William Zimmer, shown here, came within 6 days of being hanged after he snatched a 7-year-old girl from a Topeka street, then used the hammerhead of a hatchet to shatter her skull in rural Waubonsie County. This is Tim Rencher, the history guy for CJ Online, talking about that abduction and murder, which took place 55 years ago this Thursday, on November 14, 1964. Zimmer lived in Kansas City, Kansas, where he worked as a railroad engineer. He spent the night before the murder drinking in Topeka while en route to go hunting at Marysville. Zimmer abducted 7-year-old Gladys Johnson just before 8 a.m. on a Saturday in front of her younger brother and sister from this site in North Topeka, where they were waiting after finding no one at their babysitter's home. A man saw Zimmer, who was white, parked that morning with Gladys, who was African-American, in a field north of Topeka, where Zimmer told him everything was okay. Still, the man took down Zimmer's license plate number and gave it to authorities. Zimmer was arrested the following day at his brother-in-law's home at Marysville. National Guard soldiers are shown here searching the area where authorities arrested Zimmer, who initially denied having anything to do with Gladys. After a couple days in custody, Zimmer said he could recall finding the girl's body in the trunk of his 1954 Plymouth sedan, shown here, then leaving it in a rural area. Still, he said he couldn't remember killing her. Gladys Johnson's body was found 7 days after her death at this site, 4 miles northwest of St. Mary's. There was no evidence of sexual assault. A Shawnee County District Court jury found Zimmer guilty of first-degree murder and kidnapping and ordered him sentenced to death. Zimmer was 6 days away from being hanged when he got a stay of execution in 1967. His death sentence was reduced to life imprisonment in 1969 when the U.S. Supreme Court declared it unconstitutional to exclude potential jurors solely because they opposed capital punishment, which happened in Zimmer's case. Zimmer was granted parole the first time he became eligible in November 1979. He avoided legal trouble after that and died at age 95 in 2015. This is Tim Rencher, the history guy, for CJ Online.